Yes, that's right. The Survivor Know-It-Alls are back live once again after the latest Survivor episode, Stephen Fishback.
Hey, Rob Sesternino. Wow.
How are you?
What an irritating episode. What an annoying episode.
Yes, you are turned up like Donathan.
I you know what? I had so much sympathy. As Donathan lost his mind this episode, I felt like I was losing my mind this episode, you know? I mean, granted, he's like descended into pure paranoia, but I get it. If you were on Survivor and you had all of these incredible opportunities to take this game-changing move and put yourself on the top, and it was so obviously right there, and the people around you were like, nah, let's just let those two win, you might lose your mind too.
Yeah, well, he's part of the problem. He's got nobody to blame but himself.
Yes, he does. He has other people to blame, people such as Laurel. He has been pressing for this Dominic.
If he wrote Wendell down on his paper at the last tribal council, then that he is very responsible for the predicament that he's in.
Well, yeah, but he didn't know that. Like, with, you know, he was going along with his ally, with his ally Laurel, and you think Donathan is the problem here?
He has nobody to blame but himself. I mean,
he has Laurel to blame.
Everybody knew that you can't blame everything on Laurel. At this point, it looks like at least Laurel's going to go to the final three.
You don't know. Donathan could still.
Sure, but she's at least has the inside track as opposed to Donathan.
I would rather be Donathan throwing bombs at the final seven than Laurel like coasting to the goat position at the final three.
Yeah. Well, I think that you're, you know, everybody, you know, has their own perspective. I mean,
make the defense. So you're in defense of Laurel, and I want to hear it. Let's give it air.
Well, we're off to the races. We haven't even introduced the show.
But okay. I'm sorry. I'm just shocked. Right. I thought it was so transparent that Laurel was the problem here. And you know,
shot out of a cannon tonight. Let me at least set up what we're doing here tonight. Yeah. Of course, this is the Survivor Know-It-Alls. We are ready to go here live after episode number 13. Of course, we'll take your questions here live tonight. A lot coming up. We've got our exit interview coming up with Kellen tomorrow morning. I'm sure that I have a lot of questions to ask her. Hopefully we will hear from her and everything will be all set with the exit interview later on tonight. Right after this episode, I'm going to be speaking with the one and only Kim Spradlin. I will be checking in with her, and we're recording that tonight, not Thursday. So if you got a question, email me survivor@robinswebsite.com. And then of course we have got Mike Bloom coming in for the feedback show this week, so get your feedback questions in as well. All right, so Stephen is all worked up and ready to talk about Laurel
and Donathan and the whole gang. But I'm surprised. I thought I was saying like the most obvious thing, which is that Laurel is really frustrating because even though she knows she needs to make a move, she refuses to do it. In fact, I felt like the story of this episode was Laurel basically finding ways to talk herself out of making a move. You know, you can see on the one hand that she knows she needs to do this. On the other hand, she really doesn't want to because she really, really likes these guys. And so for me, what was happening this whole episode was her being like, well, I'm their friend, or, you know, well, I don't want to necessarily make a big move if it's not a smart move. And then, you know, when Wendell, there was that weirdness with Wendell at the challenge, like, well, he really could have won, so is it fair to take a shot at him here? So for me, the story of this episode was Laurel missing her last shot at eliminating Dominic and Wendell, where now with only two tribal councils left in the season, they are, you know, two vote tribal councils. If either of them wins one immunity, they're automatically in the finals, let alone, you know, any alliance voting shenanigans. So to me, it seemed like such a transparently bad play. And I felt like Donathan, you know, while he lost his mind, was, you know, at least advocating for the right goal. But you feel otherwise.
Well, here's how I look at it. I feel like that Laurel, of all people, I mean, sure, that her story has been the same for the entire post-merge. You know, she really is Hamlet. Should I? Shouldn't I? She ultimately is like the person that's in the bad relationship of like, oh, should I break up with the guy? I don't know. But at least she got some assurances that they want to go to the final three with her. So I understand the carrot that is put in front of her to make her say, like, I get where she's coming from. In it does not seem like the right decision, but you understand at least, okay, do I do a really risky thing or do I go with the safer move and get to the final three? And who knows, maybe a miracle happens. So I understand where she's coming from, even though I don't advocate necessarily what she's doing. But for the other people, and I don't understand why Donathan really just lost his mind from where he was at the end of the last episode, where it's like, hey, I'm throwing bombs at Tribal Council and I'm voting with Dominic and Wendell. Where he was, it because he didn't get picked for the reward with the, by those guys? Because he seemed to go really and get very upset and be really down on himself and start coming out to Dominic and Wendell and saying, like, I guess I'm not in the final three. Guess I'm not going to beat you guys. Where that was coming from, whereas if he would have gone along with the plan last week when he had a chance to be able to go with Kellen's plan and ultimately force a tie vote against Wendell at the previous Tribal Council at the final eight, that would have been doing something. I talked about this with Michael Snow, that the I'm sure you caught that in that podcast, Stephen, but the story of the season has been that somebody says, hey, let's vote out Dominic and Wendell. And everybody's like, should we do it? No, let's tell Dominic and Wendell, this guy wants to vote you out. And then the very next episode, the same people that said, hey, let's rat on the person that said vote out Dominic and Wendell says, hey, I got an idea. Why don't we vote out Dominic and Wendell? And the next person, it's like, 10 little monkeys sleeping in the bed. One rolls out and then the same thing happens over and over again, Steven.
Yes, but that person is always Laurel. It's not like the next person then once again, weighing
everybody's options.
Literally every episode, it's been Laurel being like, should we do it or should we not do it?
But Steven, at least she's going to the final three. The three.
But hold on a second. Like, to your point about what's her thinking? Well, she knows she's going to the final three. We have that scene of them in this episode, where they say, hey, we're all going to the final three. And then we have a confessional immediately thereafter from her saying, they think I want to go to the final three with them, but I know I would lose. I know that's a bad idea. So that's what's particularly infuriating about Laurel is that, sometimes when you have these players who are being dragged to the final three, like Natalie Tenorelli in 22, like that's not almost not as irritating because it's like she's a young person who's being played very skillfully by a four-time player, and you almost don't blame her in that situation because she doesn't necessarily see what's happening. Laurel sees it happening and yet is still consciously choosing to not improve herself. But we should talk about Donathan at some point, unless you want to keep talking about Laurel.
I want to talk about everybody else that you keep going back to Laurel. I want to talk about Kellen and Seabass and Angela, because for the life of me I don't understand what they did tonight, because that Donathan is voting for Dominic. If those other three people vote for Dominic, Dominic would have gone home at this tribal council. Why couldn't they get on the same page with Donathan in this vote? Like Laurel, and Laurel, at least that she's promised a spot in the final three. The other people aren't.
Well, maybe they think they have been, right? Like we saw at the reward last week that Wendell and Dominic promised everyone there, the end as well.
But Kellen knows she's not. Angela knows she's not. Seabass says, hey, I'm not going to be a sucker fish
might think he's in that three. But Seabass is like, I don't know how you blame Seabass and not blame Laurel. Seabass is doing the exact same thing here he knows that there's a problem.
Laurel got picked to go to the final three. Those two guys are swearing up and down to Laurel, hey, at least you're in the final three. We see all these conversations. Maybe they're having a conversation with CBF, but we're not seeing it on the show outside of with Aunt Patty at the reward challenge last week. Seabass, he's been aligned with Kellen at points during the game. If he goes with Kellen and Angela and Donathan, isn't that four have a really great shot to upset the power structure?
Yeah, I was really surprised that they didn't make that move, but it doesn't seem like there's any, it seems like Seabass is totally outside of it. And to some degree, you have to give a lot of credit to Wendell and Dominic because the thing, to some degree, to an incredible degree, because they're mm-hmm. playing an amazing game, but they're the ones who are, as all of these other factions just can't get on the same page. Well, the reason for that is because Wendell and Dominic are doing such a superb job of keeping them on different pages. You know, they brought Laurel with them on Reward. They sent Seabass off to Ghost Island. Not only does that show trust to Seabass, but it also keeps Seabass out of earshot of Kellan and Donathan, where he might get pulled into one of those schemes. So that was a pretty brilliant play. And of course, the third thing that it does is that it puts a potential advantage in the hands of the person who is least likely to play it correctly.
Yeah, that is a good call. Dominic and Wendell, they have been incredible, no doubt. And I almost felt like that this Reward challenge was almost a perfect metaphor for the entire season, where here are these two guys somehow that I don't know what the draft order was. How did they even end up being together on the same team? Of course they win the challenge. Of course they pick Laurel to be the third person right to go with them. It was just the season in a nutshell, that Reward challenge.
But it was almost like Marquesas-esque. You know, did you feel like there was any hubris there? Like, you know, just like the level of dominance, it sort of reminded
Marquesas-esque,
you know, in that great, in the pecking order challenge,
the
pecking order challenge. Yeah. Where it was like, just so transparent, like these are the ones on top. Well, and these are the ones on the bottom.
And that speaks to what I'm talking about. Other four people,
right?
Not clearly see, oh, okay, Laurel is obviously the third, and maybe Dominic and Wendell say, nah, listen, Seabass, no, you're with us. Like, are you sure? Yeah. And you know, that's that. But again, there's so much that we don't know. At the tribal council, they talked about, okay, everybody, hey, look, we're on the hammock plan. But was the hammock plan what we saw in the episode? Was the hammock
votes? That was the crazy thing.
But why would Kellan go along with that plan?
Yeah. Well, so I don't, that is one of the big questions, is that we have to find out who knew about the vote split. Because if Kellan knew about the vote split and then didn't try to, you know, short circuit it with a vote for Dominic, that seems like a real missed opportunity. It's very possible, you know, at some point at tribal council, Dominic whispers to someone like 3-2 vote split within earshot of Angela. You know, so there is a missed connection here, where if they know that there's a split vote on these two guys, there's such an easy opportunity to vote out Dominic.
That's what I'm saying. You have these four people that could have played the vote. I mean, the frustrating thing as a viewer is that once again, that it's like the Keystone Cops with all these other players. And again, so much credit to Dominic and Wendell, who've done a fantastic job. But again, time after time, that the shot is there if they all got on the same page, and then they don't even have to play their idols. So now here we go into the finale 1 week from tonight, and now we have the final six and the final five. Each of those guys has an idol. We find out tonight Wendell has a fake idol. Dominic has a fake idol.
Yeah, they both have idols and fake idols.
They both have an idol and a fake idol. You know that one of them is going to win immunity, at least one of those two votes.
Yeah.
And so it's just so frustrating to see, you know, Donathan is saying, hey, I'm with you guys. And what do the other three people do? We're going to vote for Donathan tonight.
It's crazy. I actually somewhat understood Donathan's point of view, where like he has put his game in these two baskets. Either he is going to make a big move with his ally Laurel to, you know, take out these power players, or he's going to coast with these power players, Wendell and Dominic. But then at that Reward challenge, Donathan sees that he doesn't have either of those options. You know, Laurel is you know, a collaborator basically. And, you know, then he's not picked for anything from Wendell and Dominic. And then when Wendell and Dominic come back, they're like, oh yeah, we're with you. We're totally with you. And then they start like whispering and scheming right in front of him. And he is like, hey, if I'm in your alliance, like you should tell me what you're whispering and scheming about. And they treat him like he's crazy. Like they're actually gaslighting him. You know, they're treating him like he's insane for being suspicious of something that he should be suspicious about. So I got that for Donathan. His feeling was, I'm out of like my Laurel plan is malfunctioning. My Wendell and Dominic plan is malfunctioning. All I have at my disposal right now is to throw some bombs out here.
Yeah, but he did a bad job, I thought, one, with the way that he was trying to build a rift between, or open a rift between Dominic and Wendell when he sits with Wendell in the shelter and is like, hey, I guess I'm not going in the final three. And just so you know, I'm voting for Dominic. It was like he sort of like created this self-fulfilling prophecy where I don't even think that he was somebody that those two guys were thinking about getting rid of at that point in time. And he almost like forced the issue to the point when they were really considering getting rid of him, that he handled the whole thing so poorly. The correct read would have been for him to identify, okay, I'm not in the final three. I need to jump ship. I don't need to throw bombs because I know both of these guys have immunity idols, so I don't want to arouse any suspicion, and I need to very quietly start talking with Kellen and Seabass and Angela about a plan. I don't know why he was, you know, creating so much havoc at the camp about this.
Well, isn't trying to get Wendell and Dominic to turn on each other actually like a better plan than trying to get like Seabass? I mean, I agree, obviously, I think we're all on the same page. Jonathan went really off the rails tonight in the most wonderful way. You know, his belief that the real plan was to give Kellen an idol and blindside him is like so far out there that it can, you know, it's
didn't even make any sense. It didn't make any sense about that. Boy, they were going to somehow vote for Kellen and then play an idol on her and then have him. You know,
it made zero sense. However, like the idea of creating dissension between Wendell and Dominic, like that to me seems like not a bad idea. The idea of saying to Wendell, you've got to get rid of Dominic because you will lose to him. Like that to me seems like a decent plan.
I would think that voting with the other people that aren't in the final three has a better chance of working than getting Wendell to flip on Dominic because that Jonathan's jury vote is going to be for Dominic if he's in the final.
I think everyone is thinking at this point, like, how do I really, everyone but Laurel is thinking at this point, how do I really win this game? And you know, so I feel like that's a little bug that like
I don't know why you keep singling out Laurel, because I feel like that when you have people like Angela and Seabass are also, you know, how are you, you know, only damning Laurel?
Higher standards. I have higher standards for her. Like, honestly, that's it. Like, I think she's an incredibly smart person. She's so far proven to be a really rational, a really rational player of the game. She knows the game incredibly well. We've seen her in confessional after confessional recognizing the situation she's in. So she's the only one where we have all this stack of evidence, you know, where we have her saying again and again, I know I have to get these guys out. I know this is my last chance. And then she doesn't do it. And that's very, very frustrating to see a player who knows better and takes the wrong action anyway, and especially a player who I really like. You know, who I really want to succeed.
I found myself more frustrated with Kellen tonight. I really did, just because that she has the conversation with Donathan and Donathan says, hey, I want to vote for Dominic, and why she's still on board with this plan to put the votes against Donathan. I know that maybe she was told, hey, it's going to be a split vote. We're going to put three votes on you and three votes on Donathan. And so you better put your vote on Donathan. Otherwise it's not going to get to the tie break. And then we'll split the vote against Donathan. But I mean, that's just rampant speculation.
Yeah. It is crazy. And, you know, obviously there's like, you know, we're just, again, like we're like arranging these pieces. Like, well, what about this combination? What about this combination? Like, these guys have all lived with each other for over a month. You know, there's a lot of history here. Some of them may hate each other. Some of them may be best friends. And, you know, we don't have a great sense of that. And I think probably that, I mean, we know who's best friends, but, you know, in terms of like who hates each other, who's refuses to work with each other, who doesn't trust each other at all, you know, that really goes into these votes in a major way. And we don't necessarily have the best sense of that. And that might be defining why some of these combinations aren't working more than just pure strategic considerations.
Steven, can I talk about Dominic and Wendell?
I would love it.
Okay.
They're so good.
I'd like to talk about some things that I thought that Wendell did especially well tonight, maybe even better than Dominic.
Wow.
If that's okay. I really think that in the Dominic and Wendell relationship, when we're trying to look for any separation between the two of them,
right.
I do think that Wendell ends up looking better in these moments where it's Dominic and Wendell. For instance, Donathan getting upset. Wendell, I feel like, will say less in these confrontations. Yeah,
that's interesting.
And let Dominic be more of the aggressor in terms of the mom and dad, where dad ends up being more stern. And then I believe that people end up with more animosity towards dad here in the relationship. I feel like that Chris Noble went out of the game being more upset with Dominic than Wendell. Obviously, he didn't get to see the confessional that we got to see on the episode, and we saw Dominic voting for Chris Noble very loudly. We had Donathan here, who seemed to be more upset with Dominic than Wendell during that moment. And I kind of feel like that those guys were not great in that moment about the, hey, I can't just give something to my friend. I had his thing. I had to give my friend his thing. Okay. That you don't have to see everything. Why do we have to share? Why do we have to share everything? And Wendell was right there too, saying like, hey, you know, you want to look in my bag too? That's fine. But I feel like that Dominic comes off as more of the heavy, more of the bad guy in those scenarios. And I don't know if that's intentional or not, or that's Wendell's personality, but I feel like between the two of them, that Dominic comes off more as bad cop and Wendell comes off more as good cop. And I feel like in a scenario where they both get to the end, I think that the jury will look more towards the good cop than the bad cop.
Well, that's interesting. I really, really, I think that's a really interesting read, because I've long predicted that Wendell was going to take it all. And, you know, it's interesting that to see like how, and I think that's like one interesting way it might happen. I mean, you know, again,
we're splitting hairs here, but yeah. I like the split.
Yeah. So sometimes though, the jury goes for the more dynamic player because they're more visible, you know, they, speaking from experience, they have a sense of what that person did, you know, whereas maybe their people aren't as aware, but it does seem like actually it is splitting hairs, because like Wendell, obviously everyone's very aware of Wendell as being equally a part of this you know incredible duo with Dominic. And I think that's a really smart read. That's a really great call.
And to also add to that, I want to go back to the very controversial moment between Wendell and Laurel at the immunity challenge, where Wendell completes his puzzle and then walks away and is waiting for Jeff to say, Wendell, it's immunity.
Wow.
And then Laurel ends up slide puzzle, boom, Jeff, I got it. And then and Wendell's like, hold on. I you know, I had
what
it.
Do you,
I
what
had
was, it. Was your call? You agree with the ruling, right? That he had to say Jeff.
Yeah, he should have to say Jeff.
He did like a flourish, you know, like I'm done flourish, but yes. The flourish is not enough.
Yes, it was kind of like he did the thing like, do I have it? Do I have it?
Oh, I thought that was like, boom, I nailed it, guys. Like,
I think a boom is like a literal, you know, he didn't do that. He said he kind of just like backed away, like he's like, he's also like double checking his work. I know his hands off the board, but the interesting thing though, Steven, if this was Big Brother, that he would have had it. They would have gone back. A Big Brother would go back, check the tape. I think this came up in Celebrity Big Brother as well over the season. They'll go back and they'll do a photo finish. Interesting on Survivor, it's more like baseball and like balls and strikes, where, you know, whatever the umpire says, there's no sort of you know, manager challenge here, that Jeff is the arbiter. They won't do a photo finish here.
But I, you know, there unless are Jeff lawyers, wants like, it. Yeah, I'm surprised that, you know, do you think if Wendell had contested it, that Wendell might have won? I mean, it's irrelevant. Well,
here's where I want to go with this, because I think that Wendell was very savvy to not contest it.
Oh, totally.
I think that speaks to the same sort of good cop, you know, attitude that he's fostering with the other people. And in the same way that they brought Laurel with them on the reward, I think bringing Laurel or gifting Laurel the immunity, and I don't want to say gift because she won it, but to not contest it and not create animosity with Laurel, where then she ends up saying, you know what, screw Wendell. He really was an a-hole during that whole thing. Even if it, you know, ends up going in his favor or whatever, he didn't create a rift. And we even saw her after the challenge say, I, you know, how could I go after Wendell? after I did that. Now, I saw you on Twitter and correctly say, look, this is Survivor. You can't be thinking along those lines of, I can't go after a person because they, you know, it doesn't matter, you know, what they did to you. We've seen it, but, you know, it is the kind of thing where, you know, just like Dawn and Brenda, if Laurel took out Wendell on this vote after he gave her the immunity, then I think that it would be the kind of thing where, you know, he really might lay into her, you know, at the final three.
Make her take out her teeth.
Who knows?
Yeah.
Who knows? Wendell was, I think, very astutely had the great route. Now, if this was him and Kellen, would he have fought it? I believe he would have.
Maybe. I mean, I do really think, you know, I've criticized Laurel a lot for privileging friendship over strategy. I mean, that is one of the hardest parts of the game, is, you know, divorcing strategy from these deep emotional connections you make. But you also really have to credit both Wendell and Dominic for so consciously, continuously reinforcing that friendship and that sense of loyalty with Laurel. I mean, Wendell has a confessional when they take Laurel on a ward, where he basically explicitly says they're doing that. You know, they're like trying to build up her loyalty, trying to build up her friendship. So it's not like she's not making this move out of some, you know, irrational, you know, force. It's like this is an emotion that has built up over time and has been deliberately cultivated by these two extremely intelligent players. So you know, there's that. One thing I want to say, I tweeted this, but for all future Survivor players, you always call Jeff not when you're done, but before you're done. Call Jeff just before
right. There's no time penalty if you ask Jeff to check your work and then you're
it
not
stops
right.
Other people, because like people will be like looking over, they'll be watching him.
And I never heard that before.
You can check your work while Jeff is coming over, and so as soon as he's gone, you're like, here's fixing it.
Right. That's interesting. I like that. Steven, I want to go visit something that Laurel said in the episode about how she said to the guys, look, my best chance is to go to the final three with both of you, help you guys split the vote, and, you know, I end up coming up out on top. Do you feel like, is there any merit? And I know she said that she was just saying that because that's what the guys wanted to hear. But do you think, is there any wisdom in that? Is it better for Laurel to go to the end with both of those guys versus going to the end with one of them?
Yes. I was just thinking this last week. 100%. If Laurel has the opportunity to go with both of them, it's much, much better than just going with one of them.
Yeah. I mean, because if she does pick up the Malolo vote, hypothetically, what are there? Are there three Malolo on the jury in
Libby, Jenna, I guess Donovan, in this scenario, Michael, Donathan. Yeah. Yeah.
So, you know, if she could get the four Malolo, and then, you know, if they somehow split the other Naviti, three and two, you know, that I guess there is that crack. I guess the reason why I'm not killing Laurel like you are is I just feel like if she makes the flip, you know, what, like, give me the next, you know, five moves that she makes. Great. After that.
Okay. So this episode, she makes the flip with Kellen and, Kellen and Angela and Donathan and herself. That's a four person majority in a seven person tribe. Then that four goes to the final four. And she's in, she's got it, you know, like,
yeah, but you don't think that Kellen, you know, because she exposed herself to the risk that, you know, that Kellen and Angela flip back with Seabass and then take out her and Donathan and then go to the final three. So it's not like a slam dunk. If she did make the flip.
No. And we don't know her relationships with those. You know, we don't know her relationship with Kellen, et cetera. And, you know, Wendell and Dominic both have idols. I mean, the thing that I do, so like, you know, vote out one, you know, the other one has still got a good shot of making it. So maybe there's that danger in her head too. I mean, I don't think, I see this a lot where people say, well, she's a Malolo, so she's going to get all the Malolo votes.
No.
Actually, if anything, it's likely that the people who were on her tribe, who she betrayed and voted out, are going to be more bitter towards her for being, you know, tribal traitor.
Yeah. Did she betray any of the Malolo though?
Libby.
Libby went out when they voted for Michael, and she went out. I mean, Libby voted for Michael too, I think. So I don't think that they look at that as a betrayal. I mean, I'm just like, in terms of the calculus of it, in terms of from where Laurel is coming from, where she might feel like, hey, do I have a 2% chance to beat Dominic and Wendell? And if I go the other way, do I have a you know, 10% chance, a 15% chance?
But I said this. I still thought the time to do it was last week. I mean, you know, rather than this week where it's so tight, where now you really like have to get both of them out. Mm-hmm. You know, it seemed like,
here's the thing.
Like, how are you not being so hard on her? You were tougher.
Because I feel like everybody's killing her. I feel like that's the easy thing to do.
Frustrating experience. And like, we can, you know, I agree we should analyze it and talk through it, but it's also, you know, I think we're allowed to have our subject, you know, we're fans of this show. We can have our subjective.
She's the one, at least I see what she's being offered. The other people, I feel like that after tonight, you know, these other people have like a very small slim shot, whereas if they would have pulled the trigger against Dominic tonight, they had a really good shot.
It is interesting. I mean, so next time, you know, the four of them split the votes on Dominic and Seabass. You know, they vote out Dominic tonight, then they split them votes on Wendell and Seabass.
Who does?
The four, the Kellen, Angela. This is my fan fiction four, right? The Laurel, Donathan, Kellen, and Angela, who, you know, probably don't like each other at all, right? Because they've voted against each other repeatedly. Mm-hmm. So, but in my mind, like, that would be the strategic move for all these guys. You know, vote out Dominic tonight, split the votes next week on Seabass and Wendell, vote out the remaining one, and then boom, you're in the four.
Does Sebastian getting the extra vote tonight, which I did like that they brought back a vote that Kellen misplayed earlier this season. I thought that was a nice touch when they said, it's the secret vote against McKellen. Like, Michaela, what? yes. And then Kellen misplayed it also earlier this season. So
you liked them bringing, I was so salty. Yeah.
Why? You want your vote?
Yes.
Maybe it comes back in the finale.
I wanted the curse reversed.
Maybe it'll come back in the finale. Who knows? Look, the curse is waiting for you to come back.
I know the curse is waiting, not the reversal.
Yeah. But so Sebastian having an extra vote here at the final six, does that create any possibility there for him? To me, I just feel like nothing matters because Dominic and Wendell still have their idols.
Yeah. I mean, that's the frustrating thing. Like, and another reason they should have made a move on Dominic and Wendell prior is just to A, blindside them before they were playing their idols, and B, you know, or just take multiple shots. But at this point, I mean, does Sebastian recognize the problem with Dominic and Wendell, you know, like that not being the remora?
Yeah, I don't know. I think he might feel like that, hey, he's made enough, you know, relationships with people, and maybe he has relationships that he thinks that maybe other people don't have, where he might feel like, hey, I've got Chris Noble, I've got Jenna, I've got maybe, you know, the Kellens and Angelas of the world. And he might look at it like, I'm friends with different people than those two guys are specifically. So he might feel like that he's got a different show, maybe Libby too. So he might just think that his social game is the best.
Yeah. Yeah, it's possible. I mean, and it could be one of those things. I remember, I mean, I always go back to this, but in, you know, Survivor South Pacific, everyone was like, yeah, Brandon Hance made it to the end, he would have swept the votes. And all the viewers were like, what? What are you talking about? It could be one of those things.
Did you agree with the decision to take out Kellen over Donathan for Dominic and Wendell tonight?
Yeah, definitely. That's a no-brainer. I mean, Kellen has ties to both Angela and Seabass that Donathan doesn't really have. Kellen's proven to be better in challenges. Kellen's probably more strategic. You know, probably got a better shot at the jury. I think that's, yeah, for sure.
Yeah. You know, just to go back to something we touched on a little bit with, in terms of the Dominic putting the thing in Wendell's bag and Donathan called that out. The other thing about those, the other people, the other four that could have voted together tonight, I feel like that they didn't make enough of a big deal about that. I don't know why Kellen wasn't. Yeah. Yay, what was that you put in his bag? What is this thing that you can't talk about? They never even gave like a good answer of like, oh no, that was a shell that I picked up on the beach. And, you know, Seabass got me talking about shells. And now I collect shells too. And I had this shell I wanted. Like, it was just like, whoa, it was a thing. Why do I have to show you everything? And that I just don't know why the other people did not, that did not arouse enough suspicion of, I have a secret and I want to tell Wendell. I don't have to tell you guys.
Well, but it seemed like their point was to arouse suspicion, right? They wanted it to seem like they were passing idols back and forth so that there was this, the fear of an idol. And honestly, like that might've played a small role in why nobody voted for.
So you feel like they wanted to have that happen.
Yeah. I mean, the purpose of a fake idol, you know, you had that confessional from Wendell about, well, I've got this fake idol that I made. And the whole point of a fake idol is just to, you know, freak people out. So
is that too cute? Why not both wear their idols at tribal council at that point?
Yeah, I don't know. That's it. Like they're like, I honestly like when I was playing with JT, like I sort of we felt at some point where it was like we were just doing things to do them because like we felt like we were so completely in control of the game. And I kind of had the sense that that's what was happening with like here with Dominic and Wendell, where they're like, you know what would be fun? Let's do this, you know, because they're so running the show.
I just thought that Donathan was being pouty at tribal council and not really like, you wanted to come and drop truth bombs. Like come you're at tribal council. Now's the time. Let's get those truth bombs going. Get Kellen, get Seabass, get Angela on your side. Hey, these guys are going to play an idol. And you know, I just felt like that he was when, Dominic says to him, like, Donathan, can I talk to you? And he's like, no.
Yeah.
Like, okay. Well, what good does that do? No,
I agree, but at this point, I mean, I don't know. You're just losing your mind by this point, you know. To see all of the game. I'm sure he can see the game collapsing around him. And look, I think it's great that one of us is partisanly defending Donathan, and the other is partisanly defending Laurel, and they're both wonderful people.
Look, for Donathan though, that I feel like he was the only one out of that four that voted correctly. That he was the one person that put his vote in the right spot
of that five.
Let's not keep saying the same thing. Somebody has to feel like I'm going to the final three with Wendell and Dominic. So. Yeah. At least that spot is taken, but for the other three people that aren't going to go to the final three with them, I feel like that, you know, that the shot was there to take. Also, Steven, I want to ask you about the reward challenge, very similar to the final three challenge.
Oh, fantastic. This was great. It was such a cool challenge, and it really, you know, it involved teamwork, it involved physicality, it involved, you know, like there's some strategic element to the timing. I just loved it.
Yeah. No, really cool challenge and very fun to watch. All right. We're going to get to the questions here. Just a reminder, canvaspeople.com. Get a 11 by 14 canvas photo for $0 pricing. You just pay the shipping when you use promo code RHAP at canvaspeople.com for that 11 by 14 photo size. Steven, Timmy Samari says, do you think that the big reason that the group went with Kellen on the revote is because Donathan is seen at the GOAT as the GOAT at this point? It's very interesting. We did not get to see the votes on the revote in the final words. We only saw the 3-3 where it was Dominic, Wendell, and Laurel again together voting against Kellen. And then the other three people voted against Donathan. We didn't get to see what the votes were on the revote. Yeah. I presume that there was only that one vote that was against Donathan, but we don't know who cast it.
Yeah, it is really interesting. And it seemed like I kind of got the sense that they were like, well, let's see what happens. You know, they were kind of like shrugging. Yeah.
No, that's a great point. The interaction between Wendell and Angela at that point. Again, they talked about, hey, remember the hammock plan, everybody? Remember that? And then Angela like turned back to Wendell, like, what are we doing here? And Wendell just gave her like a shrug, like, oh, I don't know. You figure it out. Whatever you want to do. And I think that Angela was the person that voted against Donathan, if I had to guess.
I think that was the sense I got too. And is it because, I mean, we talked about this a little bit, like, is it because he's more of a GOAT? It's probably that he's less of a jury threat than Kellen. He's less of a physical threat than Kellen you know, maybe somewhat, and he has fewer connections to the people left in the game. You know, Kellen had that connection, you know, with Angela, they voted together last episode. She's obviously, you know, been with Seabass a long time. So, you know, as part of that Navidi, the core Navidi group. So it really makes sense for those guys to isolate all the different factions around them. Ultimately, if people don't want to work together, they're not going to work together. I mean, you know, again, like with token chains, like that was our situation, was there were enough people to vote me and JT out, but they all hated each other. Coach and Taj hated each other, which was great. That was what we wanted.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Then I think that the, Scott, let me know if we're stuck here or if we got another question ready to go. Wyatt wants to know, do you think that there might be some crazy twist in the finale, considering that the finale is at 6 rather than 5? No, I think that's pretty much standard protocol on these 20 player seasons. We had that certainly in your season, Stephen, in the infamous 0-0 vote at in Cambodia. We also had a final 6 in the finale in Survivor, Survivor Millennials versus Gen X. And I think we also had the same thing going back to the advantage get in with Suri at Game Changers. Stephen, do you think that we are headed towards another advantage get in here? I mean, we have what? Dominic's idol, Wendell's idol. We have the Sebastian extra vote. Are there any other advantages or idols currently in the game?
No, other than all the fake stuff.
And then there's a bunch of fake stuff. And then somebody's going to go to Ghost Island in the next episode. And you would imagine that for the final Ghost Island trip, they will give some hardware out as well.
Yeah, let's hope so. It would have to be something like an extra vote or something. Maybe it's a remove a juror. Although I guess Michelle played that correctly. Mm-hmm. So not cursed.
And you don't have any guarantee that the person that would go to Ghost Island is going to be in the final three.
Yeah. Yeah. Tricky. Interesting.
Could be your vote steal.
It's too late. I've given up on that. Although that'd be fun if there were like 9 votes in the final 6, you know? All right. Zach Wright wants to know. All right. There are 7 people left and everyone knows Wendelick are in the lead. Is Wendelick a thing? If first place is the goal, one of them should have been voted out tonight. Is everyone else now just playing for the third place cash prize?
Basically, yes. Yeah. Yeah. But third place is better than 7th place.
It's a lot better. Amanda Fallon wants to know, Wendell and Dom both didn't have great nights in front of the jury. Will it matter?
Yeah. I would say that I don't think that... Did Wendell have a bad night in front of the jury?
I didn't think so. I mean, maybe the...
I don't think that Dominic had a terrible night by any stretch of the imagination, but I think that Donathan came across like pissed off against more towards Dominic. And I think that Laurel, again, she could be in the final three. It might be a good idea for Wendell to see somebody else in the final three because he's going to pick up that Laurel vote, you would imagine. But thought he had a good night with Laurel.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, for sure. I mean, did you think he come off badly at all in the challenge? I thought he came off really well, but
who?
Wendell.
Came off badly in what way?
Just like he was gracious, but he also looked pretty irritated. I mean, I'm just raising the issue. I thought he came off really well, but someone texted me saying that they thought he came off like kind of jerky.
A blind item. No, I don't think he came off like a jerk. Anybody in his situation, I think he handled it better than 95% of other survivors would have.
Yeah. Yeah. For sure. I would have been pretty annoyed. All right. Edmo.
Edward.
Sorry. I just saw Ed and then I filled in Mo. Edward wants to know, should Wendell have contested Jeff's ruling more? And does ruling on the field always stand?
You know, the only time that I can think of that we had a similar situation was back in Survivor Pearl Islands, where I believe that Burton was awarded immunity in a word find puzzle. And then they went back. And then after Jeff had said Burton had the correct word, then do you remember this? They went back and huddled with production and said, actually, that was a misspelled word.
Yeah.
And then Burton was out. And I believe that Dara came up with it, but I might have it backwards in terms of who the original winner was, but I think I have that right.
Yeah, no, I do recall that, but that's a little interesting. It's a little different where Burton was wrong.
Yeah. This would have been like if Jeff said that Wendell was the winner, but then upon further review, his puzzle was actually wrong.
Oh, that's totally different. But
yeah,
this in that where he actually had it right, he was right before he did do the flourish. Mm-hmm.
Believe me, every survivor from now on, this will never happen again.
Yeah.
Okay. Scott wants to know, did Wendell make a bad move by refusing to give Angela guidance on who to vote for in the revote?
I don't think so. I think if Wendell is calling someone out in the revote, it looks a little bit like Godfather-y. You know, I think for him to be like, hey, you know, vote your conscience here.
Yeah. Don't look at me. I'm not the one. I didn't tell everybody to vote for this person.
Yeah.
Okay. Aaron wants to know, wouldn't it have been smarter to oust Donathan as he was the loose cannon and Kellen would have continued to act as a shield for Dominic and Wendell? I think like that Steven laid out the case pretty well. I think that in terms of, you know, keeping the Keystone Cops together, it does feel like that Kellen, that, you know, and well, I'm sure we'll talk a ton about Kellen over these next couple of podcasts, but, you know, she, the picture for Kellen was, and it's great that we're going to talk to Kim, but she was the person with the Kim upside. She was the person that was going to be able to go back and pick up all of the pawns. And I think that when eventually the story is written for this season, I think that we're going to look at Kellen as the person who had the most blunders along the way, because I think that she was the one that she was the one person, I think, that you could have, you know, drawn the path through the maze for her to get to the end and win. She had all of the numbers that if she could have gotten them together against Dominic and Wendell, I think that she could have gotten to the end of this game.
Yeah, I agree. I think, you know, I sort of thought this was like a muted farewell for one of the season's biggest players. She didn't have a big episode. Yeah, not at all. She didn't really do that much that we saw. Maybe she was scrambling behind the scenes. You know, she was, and you know, most people early on were predicting her to go all the way. And
she was my winner pick.
Yeah, and you know, it really did seem her, you know, I agree with you. I think that she was so focused on this issue of Navidi Strong, and the edge for Dominic and Wendell has been this alliance with Laurel and then also with Donathan up until now. So, you know, it really did seem, you know, let this be a lesson to all future Survivor players that how important it is to keep strategic options open with people from every part of the game.
Yeah, going back to the point in the game around when Libby went out, that, you know, it seemed like that there were votes where Wendell especially was vulnerable. Going back to that split tribal council vote, if she puts her double vote on Wendell there instead of on Laurel, it's a completely different game. She has to vote out Desiree, who's one of her numbers, who is trying to make a move against her. But just, you know, time after time after time, you know, 4 weeks in a row, this was a big fall for Kellen.
Well, she almost peaked too soon. Like, she became like the big target like too early, and then her people turned on her too early. And you know, if had it right now, right, is when like Dominic and Wendell's people are turning on them, and it's like too late. But you know, like 3 or 4 votes ago was when Dez turned on Kellen, and you know, at that point it was bad.
And maybe one of the underrated moves of the season, you know, and it happened at the time and we were sort of like, I don't really get this, was when Dominic took out Bradley, because it does seem like that was her ride or die based on what we had heard from everybody. And so here comes Dominic into the merge. He's reunited with Wendell, who's his number one partner in the game. And now Kellen really never had a number one the rest of the way. She had all of these other minions like Desiree and Angela and Chelsea, but she never had anybody who was an equal that she could share the information with. And ultimately she's out at the final 7.
Yeah. And at the time, I know that I said it was a terrible move on Dominic's part. Mea culpa. I was completely wrong. That was obviously,
we get things wrong. Okay. It's not a big deal.
Yeah, constantly.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
A couple more questions. What about Scott Ring?
All right. Scott Ring wants to know, is Dom and Wen's "how dare you think to make a move against me / we can't be touched" attitude going to rub the jurors the wrong way? I think there's a little bit of cockiness kind of bleeding into the game.
Yeah. I mean, who are they giving? I mean, I get it that us viewers are getting that, but who in the game is walking away from it? I mean, Kellen, who went out of the game, seemed to go out with a very positive attitude. And, you know, I guess maybe that's just Kellen, but I don't feel like that the other players are too salty outside of Donathan.
Yeah. I mean, you know, it's true. It's true. I agree. It's such a small thing too. You know, when they were at the challenge, they were like, "Oh, this is easy. I knew exactly who to pick." You know, it was a little bit like, pretend that it's hard.
Seemed like they didn't really consult Laurel on that one.
Well, no, they were told not to consult Laurel.
Yeah. Okay. No, they weren't allowed to. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. John Bledsoe says there was a good amount of urns to be smashed at Ghost Island. Next week is the finale. How many more advantages are going to enter the game? Yeah, Stephen, it seems like that the whole thing was smash the urn, and there were going to be, it was going to like time out to how many weeks there were on the show. It seems like there was, by my count, like 5 or 6 urns left to be smashed.
Yeah, maybe they were just in case someone like smashed an extra urn, just got carried away with all the smashing.
No, well, who knows? All right, what about Dennis?
Dennis wants to say, hey, Rob, excuse me. Do you think Kellen would have had the chance to win the same advantage tonight and possibly read a parchment talking about how she screwed up earlier this season? Or would Survivor have changed the events? That would have been funny.
Yeah, that would have been funny. The tin cup idol of where she would have had a chance to have the do-over to not screw it up again. Yeah. And it would have been great if she would have screwed up the same piece of paper again.
Yeah.
What she should have done, and then she could vote Laurel again, like circle it, like no, like with arrows like pointing to Laurel this time.
I finally get that Michael vote.
Yeah. Okay. Let's do one more question here with Steven tonight. Eric Corbin, the great Eric Corbin. Hey guys, any chance at all that Donathan is acting here and the four are all still together?
No.
Let me check the magic eight ball on that one. Yeah. Sources say no, Steven.
They almost voted him out.
Yeah, no, I don't think so. I don't think he's that talented of an actor, sadly. Yeah. Okay, all right. Let me tell you about what's coming up, Stephen Fishback. Okay, exit interview tomorrow. I am very excited to talk to Real Kellen tomorrow morning, and it should be a great time. And then Kim Spradlin coming up next. Going to talk to Kim in about 30 minutes from now. If you have a question, email it into me, survivor@robhasawebsite.com. We've also got a thread up in the patron group. Of course, on the RHAP, B&B is going to be coming out this weekend as well. I believe Puya is going to be there with Paul Asselson. And then go ahead and check out RuPaul's Drag Race. And why so many podcasts, why Blank Lost with Dave Bloomberg and Jessica Lewis. We'll talk all about Kellen this week on the show. And of course, if you want to get even more on Rob Has a Podcast, everything that we are doing, check us out on Patreon, robhasawebsite.com/patron, for all of the extras that we offer for you to become a Rob Has a Podcast patron, because we could not do this podcast without you patrons.
And
I could not do this podcast without you, Steven.
Hey, was that Real Kellen thing off the cuff, or did you have that plan? That was very funny.
What, the Real Kellen? I mean, I don't, there's no teleprompter here.
You're very good. You're very good at this, Rob. Yeah. You're very clever. Very
thank quick, you. Quick, thank you, Steven.
Clever
thank you.
And quick-witted.
Yes, of course. You can read even more about this episode when you follow the great Stephen Fishback on Twitter. Check out his People blog as well. And Stephen, this is going to be it for you and I on the Ghost Island Know-It-Alls.
For you and me, this will be it on the Ghost Island Know-It-Alls. Yes, next week finale, we've got Rob will be schmoozing with the Glitterati at the actual finale. Mm-hmm. And I will be here holding it down with Sophie.
Yeah, Sophie Clark will be with Stephen Fishback live after the 3-hour finale and reunion special coming up on CBS next Wednesday night. And then I will have the exit interviews from the red carpet at the finale. And then Josh Wigler and I will then recap everything and take your feedback the day after the finale coming up next week as we put a bow on Survivor Ghost Island and look ahead to the long abyss of no Survivor over the summer, and then we'll come back for Survivor 37 in the fall.
Wow, 37!
When Stephen Fishback will be a married man.
Oh my God. It's totally different. My attitude towards the show will be totally different. Now when people say, you know, they start weeping about their wife back at home, I'll get teary too.
Yes. Steven, can I ask you real quick, what were you doing? I saw on Instagram that you were on some Shackleton boat ride.
Oh my God. It was so cool. I got to ride on the Alexander Shackleton, which is a perfect remodel of the James Caird, which is Shackleton's boat that he sailed through the Southern Sea from Elephant Island to South George Island in this, you know, his great Antarctic rescue mission, basically. One of the most, you know, incredible historic events. This guy I was with, Tim Jarvis, who's this explorer, he recreated this voyage and a couple years ago. And this was the first time that Tim took the Alexander Shackleton out. I was there, got to be there for his first reunion with his boat. I got to hold the ropes. I got to drive the Alexander Shackleton. God, it was so cool.
But why are you doing these things?
You know, just an opportunity, you know, hang out with Tim Jarvis, like one of the true great adventurers of our world.
Are you a big explorer nut?
Yeah. Oh my God. Yeah. I love that stuff. Rob, aren't we all, isn't that like what drives us to this crazy, you know, island based lifestyle that we've led?
Is that what led you to the island? Love of adventure. Shackleton?
Adventure.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Wow.
Is that life what you is an adventure?
Yeah.
Say yes. Yeah.
I thought that was the part you didn't like.
Yeah. No. I really like that stuff. I just wasn't that good at it.
Okay. Wow. See, yeah. You're so layered.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. All right. So follow Stephen Fishback on Twitter. Thanks so much to the great Scott St. Pierre behind the scenes. I am getting ready to talk to Kim Spradlin. Looking forward to some really fun podcasts. Get your feedback questions in for the Mike Bloom feedback show coming up this weekend. I think that should be a lot of fun as well. Stephen, did you check out Bryce Isaiah on last week's feedback show?
I haven't yet, but I heard it was great.
Yes, yes. People rave reviews for Bryce. It'll be tough to top.
Yeah, he's the best.
Did a great job. All right, take care, everybody. Have a good one.
Bye. That's what's particularly infuriating about Laurel is that, you know, sometimes when you have these players who are being dragged to the final three, you know, like Natalie Tenorelli in 22, like that's not almost not as irritating because it's like she's a young person who's being played very skillfully by a four-time player, and you almost don't blame her in that situation because she doesn't necessarily see what's happening. Laurel sees it happening and yet is still consciously choosing to not improve herself. But you know, we should talk about Donathan at some point, you know, unless you want to keep talking about Laurel.
I want to talk about everybody else that you keep going back to Laurel. I want to talk about Kellen and Seabass and Angela, because for the life of me I don't understand what they did tonight, because that Donathan is voting for Dominic. If those other three people vote for Dominic, Dominic would have gone home at this tribal council. Why couldn't they get on the same page with Donathan in this vote? Like Laurel, and Laurel, at least that she's promised a spot in the final three. The other people aren't.
Well, I mean, maybe they think they have been, right? Like we saw at the reward last week that, right, that Wendell and Dominic promised everyone there, you know, the end as well.
But Kellen knows she's not. Angela knows she's not. Seabass says, hey, I'm not going to be a sucker fish that
Seabass might think he's in that three. But Seabass is like, I mean, I don't know how you blame Seabass and not blame Laurel. Seabass is doing the exact same thing here where he knows that there's a problem.
Laurel got picked to go to the final three. Those two guys are swearing up and down to Laurel, hey, at least you're in the final three. We see all these conversations. Maybe they're having a conversation with Seabass, but we're not seeing it on the show outside of with Aunt Patty at the reward challenge last week. Seabass, he's been aligned with Kellen at points during the game. If he goes with Kellen and Angela and Donathan, isn't that four have a really great shot to upset the power structure?
Yeah, I mean, I was really surprised that they didn't make that move, but it doesn't seem like there's any, you know, It seems like Seabass is totally outside of that. And you know, to some degree, you have to give a lot of credit to Wendell and Dominic, because the thing, I mean, to some degree, to an incredible degree, because they're mm-hmm. playing an amazing game, but they're the ones who are, you know, as all of these other factions just can't get on the same page. Well, the reason for that is because Wendell and Dominic are doing such a superb job of keeping them on different pages. You know, they brought Laurel with them on reward. They sent Seabass off to Ghost Island. Not only does that show trust to Seabass, but it also keeps Seabass out of earshot of Kellen and Donathan, where he might get pulled into one of those schemes. So that was a pretty brilliant play. And of course, the third thing that it does is that it puts a potential advantage in the hands of the person who is least likely to play it correctly.
Yeah, that is a good call. The Dominic and Wendell, they have been incredible, no doubt. And I almost felt like that this reward challenge was almost a perfect metaphor for the entire season, where here are these two guys somehow that I don't know what the draft order was. How did they even end up being together on the same team? Of course they win the challenge. Of course they pick Laurel to be the third person right. to go with them. It was just the season in a nutshell, that reward challenge.
But it was almost like Marquesas-esque. You know, did you feel like there was any hubris there? Like, you know, just like the level of dominance, it sort of reminded
Marquesas-esque,
you know, in that great,
in the pecking order challenge.
Yeah. Where it was like just so transparent. Like these are the ones on top. Well, and these are the ones on
the bottom. And that speaks to what I'm talking about. Other four people.
Right.
Not clearly see? Oh, okay. Laurel is obviously the third, and maybe Dominic and Wendell say, nah, listen, Seabass. No, you're with us. Like, are you sure? Yeah. Yeah. And you know, that's that. But again, there's so much that we don't know. At the tribal council, they talked about, okay, everybody, hey, look, we're on the hammock plan. But was the hammock plan what we saw in the episode?
Was the hammock votes? That was the crazy thing.
But why would Kellan go along with that plan?
Yeah. Well, so I don't, that is one of the big questions, is that we have to find out who knew about the vote split. Because if Kellan knew about the vote split and then didn't try to, you know, short circuit it with a vote for Dominic, that seems like a real missed opportunity. It's very possible, you know, at some point at tribal council, Dominic whispers to someone like 3-2 vote split within earshot of Angela. You know, so there is a missed connection here where they know that there's a split vote on these two guys. There's such an easy opportunity to vote out Dominic.
That's what I'm saying. You have these four people that could have played the vote. I mean, the frustrating thing as a viewer is that once again, that it's like the Keystone Cops with all these other players. And again, so much credit to Dominic and Wendell, who've done a fantastic job. But again, time after time, that the shot is there if they all got on the same page, and then they don't even have to play their idols. So now here we go into the finale 1 week from tonight, and now we have the final six and the final five. Each of those guys has an idol. We find out tonight, Wendell has a fake idol. Dominic has a fake idol.
Yeah, they both have idols and fake idols.
They both have an idol and a fake idol. You know that one of them is going to win immunity, at least one of those two votes.
Yeah.
And so it's just so frustrating to see, you know, Donathan is saying, hey, I'm with you guys. I'm with you guys. And what do the other three people do? We're going to vote for Donathan tonight.
It's crazy. I actually somewhat understood Donathan's point of view, where like he has put his game in these two baskets. Either he is going to make a big move with his ally Laurel to, you know, take out these power players, or he's going to coast with these power players, Wendell and Dominic. But then at that reward challenge, Donathan sees that he doesn't have either of those options. You know, Laurel is you know, a collaborator basically. And, you know, then he's not picked for anything from Wendell and Dominic. And then when Wendell and Dominic come back, they're like, oh yeah, we're with you. We're totally with you. And then they start like whispering and scheming right in front of him. And he is like, hey, if I'm in your alliance, like you should tell me what you're whispering and scheming about. And they treat him like he's crazy. Like they're actually gaslighting him. You know, they're treating him like he's insane for being suspicious of something that he should be suspicious about. So I got that for Donathan. His feeling was, I'm out of like my Laurel plan is malfunctioning. My Wendell and Dominic plan is malfunctioning. All I have at my disposal right now is to throw some bombs out here.
Yeah, but he did a bad job, I thought, one, with the way that he was trying to. Yes, that's right. The Survivor Know-It-Alls are back live once again after the latest Survivor episode, Stephen Fishback.
Hey, Rob Sesternino. Wow.
How are you?
What an irritating episode. What an annoying, annoying episode.
Yes, you are turned up like Donathan.
I, you know what? I had so much sympathy. As Donathan lost his mind this episode, I felt like I was losing my mind this episode, you know? I mean, granted, he's like descended into pure paranoia, but I get it. If you were on Survivor and you had all of these incredible opportunities to take this game-changing move and put yourself on the top, and it was so obviously right there, and the people around you were like, nah, let's just let those two win. You might lose your mind too.
Yeah, well, he's part of the problem. He's got nobody to blame but himself.
Yes, he does. He has other people to blame, people such as Laurel. He has been pressing for this
Steven,
Dominic.
If he wrote Wendell down on his paper at the last tribal council, then that he is very responsible for the predicament that he's in.
Well, yeah, but he didn't know that. Like, with, you know, he was going along with his ally, with his ally Laurel. And you think Donathan is the problem here?
He's one of he has nobody to blame but himself. I mean,
he has Laurel to blame.
Everybody knew that you can't blame everything on Laurel. At this point, it looks like at least Laurel's going to go to the final three.
You don't know. You don't know. Donathan could still.
Sure, but she's at least on has the inside track as opposed to Donathan.
I would rather be Donathan throwing bombs at the final seven than Laurel like coasting to the goat position at the final three.
Yeah. Well, I think that you're, you know, everybody, you know, has their own perspective. I mean,
make the defense. So you're in defense of Laurel, and I want to hear it. I want you give it. Let's give it air.
Well, we're off to the races. We haven't even introduced the show.
But okay. I'm sorry. I'm just shocked. Right. I thought it was so transparent that Laurel was the problem here. And you know,
shot out of a cannon tonight. Let me at least set up what we're doing here tonight. Yeah. Of course, this is the Survivor Know-It-Alls. We are ready to go here live after episode number 13. Of course, we'll take your questions here live tonight. A lot coming up. We've got our exit interview coming up with Kellen tomorrow morning. I'm sure that I have a lot of questions to ask her. Hopefully, we will hear from her and everything will be all set with the exit interview later on tonight. Right after this episode, I'm going to be speaking with the one and only Kim Spradlin. I will be checking in with her. I'm recording that tonight, not Thursday. So if you got a question, email me survivor@robinswebsite.com. And then, of course, we have got Mike Bloom coming in for the feedback show this week. So get your feedback questions in as well. All right. So Steven is all worked up and ready to talk about Laurel
and Donathan and the whole gang. But I'm surprised. I thought I was saying like the most obvious thing, which is that Laurel is really frustrating because even though she knows she needs to make a move, she refuses to do it. In fact, I felt like the story of this episode was Laurel basically finding ways to talk herself out of making a move. You know, you can see on the one hand that she knows she needs to do this. On the other hand, she really doesn't want to because she really, really likes these guys. And so for me, what was happening this whole episode was her being like, well, I'm their friend, or, you know, well, I don't want to necessarily make a big move if it's not a smart move. And then, you know, when Wendell, there was that weirdness with Wendell at the challenge, like, well, he really could have won. So is it fair to take a shot at him here? So for me, the story of this episode was Laurel missing truly her last shot at eliminating Dominic and Wendell, where now with only two tribal councils left in the season, they are, you know, two vote tribal councils. If either of them wins one immunity, they're automatically in the finals, let alone, you know, any alliance voting shenanigans. So to me, it seemed like such a transparently bad play. And I felt like Donathan, you know, while he lost his mind, was, you know, at least advocating for the right goal. But you feel otherwise.
Well, here's how I look at it. I feel like that Laurel, of all people, I mean, sure, that her story has been the same for the entire post-merge. You know, she really is Hamlet. Should I? Shouldn't I? She ultimately is like the person that's in the bad relationship of like, oh, should I break up with the guy? I don't know. But at least she got some assurances that they want to go to the final three with her. So at least I understand the carrot that is put in front of her to make her say, like, I get where she's coming from. It does not seem like the right decision, but you understand at least, okay, do I do a really risky thing or do I go with the safer move and get to the final three? And who knows, maybe a miracle happens. So I understand where she's coming from, even though I don't advocate necessarily what she's doing. But for the other people, and I don't understand why Donathan really just lost his mind from where he was at the end of the last episode, where it's like, hey, I'm throwing bombs at tribal council and I'm voting with Dominic and Wendell. Where he was, it because he didn't get picked for the reward by those guys? Because he seemed to go really and get very upset and be really down on himself and start coming out to Dominic and Wendell and saying, like, I guess I'm not in the final three. Guess I'm not going to beat you guys. Where that was coming from. Whereas if he would have gone along with the plan last week when he had a chance to be able to go with Kellen's plan and ultimately force a tie vote against Wendell at the previous tribal council at the final eight. That would have been doing something. I talked about this with Michael Snow, that the I'm sure you caught that in that podcast, Stephen, but the story of the season has been that somebody says, hey, let's vote out Dominic and Wendell. And everybody's like, should we do it? No, let's tell Dominic and Wendell, this guy wants to vote you out. And then the very next episode, the same people that said, hey, let's rat on the person that said vote out Dominic and Wendell, says, hey, I got an idea. Why don't we vote out Dominic and Wendell? And the next person, it's like, 10 little monkeys sleeping in the bed. One rolls out, and then the same thing happens over and over again, Stephen.
Yes, but that person is always Laurel. It's not like the next person then once again, weighing
everybody's options.
Literally every episode, it's been Laurel being like, should we do it or should we not do it?
But Stephen, at least she's going to the final three. The three.
But hold on a second. Like, to your point about what's her thinking? Well, she knows she's going to the final three. We have that scene of them in this episode, where they say, hey, we're all going to the final three. And then we have a confessional immediately thereafter from her saying, they think I want to go to the final three with them, but I know I would lose. I know that's a bad idea. So that
build a rift between or open a rift between Dominic and Wendell when he sits with Wendell in the shelter and is like, hey, I guess I'm not going to the final three. And just so you know, I'm voting for Dominic. It was like he sort of like created this self-fulfilling prophecy where I don't even think that he was somebody that those two guys were thinking about getting rid of at that point in time. And he almost like forced the issue to the point when they were really considering getting rid of him, that he handled the whole thing so poorly. The correct read would have been for him to identify, okay, I'm not in the final three. I need to jump ship. I don't need to throw bombs because I know both of these guys have immunity idols. So I don't want to arouse any suspicion. And I need to very quietly start talking with Kellen and Seabass and Angela about a plan. I don't know why he was, creating so much havoc at the camp about this.
Well, isn't trying to get Wendell and Dominic to turn on each other actually like a better plan than trying to get like Seabass? I mean, I agree, obviously I think we're all on the same page. Jonathan went really off the rails tonight in the most wonderful way. His belief that the real plan was to give Kellen an idol and blindside him is like so far out there that it can, it didn't make any sense.
They were going to somehow vote for Kellen and then play an idol on her and then have him.
It made zero sense. However, the idea of creating dissension between Wendell and Dominic, that to me seems like not a bad idea. The idea of saying to Wendell, you've got to get rid of Dominic because you will lose to him. That to me seems like a decent plan.
I would think that voting with the other people that aren't in the final three has a better chance of working than getting Wendell to flip on Dominic because that Jonathan's jury vote is going to be for Dominic if he's in the final two.
But I think everyone is thinking at this point, how do I really, everyone but Laurel is thinking at this point, how do I really win this game? So I feel like that's a little bug that
I don't know why you keep singling out Laurel, because I feel like that when you have people like Angela and Seabass are also, how are you, only damning Laurel?
Higher standards. I have higher standards for her. Honestly, that's it. I think she's an incredibly smart person. She's so far proven to be a really rational, great, I mean, not a great player. She's a really rational player of the game. She knows the game incredibly well. We've seen her in confessional after confessional recognizing the situation she's in. So she's the only one where we have all this, this stack of evidence, where we have her saying again and again, I know I have to get these guys out. I know this is my last chance. And then she doesn't do it. And that's very, very frustrating to see a player who knows better and takes the wrong action anyway. And especially a player who I really like, who I really want to succeed.
Mm-hmm. I found myself more frustrated with Kellen tonight. I really did, just because that she has the conversation with Jonathan and Jonathan says, hey, I want to vote for Dominic, and why she's still on board with this plan to put the votes against Jonathan. I know that maybe she was told, hey, it's going to be a split vote. We're going to put three votes on you and three votes on Jonathan. And so you better put your vote on Jonathan. Otherwise it's not going to get to the tie break. And then we'll split the vote against Jonathan. But I mean, that's just rampant speculation.
Yeah, it is crazy. And, obviously there's you know, we're just, again, like, we're like arranging these pieces, like, well, what about this combination? What about this combination? Like, these guys have all lived with each other for over a month. You know, there's a lot of history here. Some of them may hate each other. Some of them may be best friends. And, you know, we don't have a great sense of that. And I think probably that, I mean, we know who's best friends, but, you know, in terms of like who hates each other, who's refuses to work with each other, who doesn't trust each other at all, you know, that really goes into these votes in a major way. And we don't necessarily have the best sense of that. And that might be defining why some of these combinations aren't working more than just pure strategic considerations.
Steven, can I talk about Dominic and Wendell?
I would love it.
Okay.
They're so good.
I'd like to talk about some things that I thought that Wendell did especially well tonight, maybe even better than Dominic.
Wow.
If that's okay. I really think that in the Dominic and Wendell relationship, when we're trying to look for any separation between the two of them,
right.
I do think that Wendell ends up looking better in these moments where it's Dominic and Wendell. For instance, Donathan getting upset. Wendell, I feel like, will say less in these confrontations. Yeah,
that's interesting.
And let Dominic be more of the aggressor in terms of the mom and dad, where dad ends up being more stern. And then I believe that people end up with more animosity towards dad here in the relationship. I feel like that Chris Noble went out of the game being more upset with Dominic than Wendell. Obviously, he didn't get to see the confessional that we got to see on the episode, and we saw Dominic voting for Chris Noble very loudly. We had Donathan here, who seemed to be more upset with Dominic than Wendell during that moment. And I kind of feel like that those guys were not great in that moment about the, hey, I can't just give something to my friend. I had his thing. I had to give my friend his thing. Okay. That you don't have to see everything. Why do we have to share? Why do we have to share everything? And Wendell was right there too, saying like, hey, you know, you want to look in my bag too? That's fine. But I feel like that Dominic comes off as more of the heavy, more of the bad guy in those scenarios. And I don't know if that's intentional or not, or that's Wendell's personality, but I feel like between the two of them, that Dominic comes off more as bad cop and Wendell comes off more as good cop. And I feel like in a scenario where they both get to the end, I think that the jury will look more towards the good cop than the bad cop.
Well, that's interesting. I really, really, I think that's a really interesting read, because I've long predicted that Wendell was going to take it all. And, you know, it's interesting that to see like how, and I think that's like one interesting way it might happen. I mean, you know,
again, we're splitting hairs here, but I like the split.
Yeah. So sometimes though, the jury goes for the more dynamic player because they're more visible, you know, they, mm-hmm. I'm speaking from experience. Mm-hmm. They have a sense of what that person did, you know, whereas maybe their people aren't as aware, but it's out, are going to be more bitter towards her for being, you know, tribal traitor.
Yeah. Did she betray any of them, Lolo, though?
Libby.
Libby went out when they voted for Michael, and she went out. Michael. I mean, Libby voted for Michael too, I think. So I don't think that they look at that as a betrayal. I mean, I'm just like, in terms of the calculus of it, in terms of from where Laurel is coming from, where she might feel like, hey, do I have a 2% chance to beat Dominic and Wendell? And if I go the other way, do I have a, you know, 10% chance, a 15% chance?
But I said this, I still thought the time to do it was last week. I mean, you know, rather than this week where it's so tight, where now you really like have to get both of them out. Mm-hmm. It seemed like,
here's the thing.
Like, how are you not being so hard on her? You were tougher.
Because I feel like everybody's killing her. I feel like that's the easy thing to do.
Frustrating experience. And like, we can, you know, I agree we should analyze it and talk through it, but it's also, you know, I think we're allowed to have our subject, you know, we're fans of this show. We can have our subject.
She's the one, at least I see what she's being offered. The other people, I feel like that after tonight, you know, these other people have like, you know, a very small, slim shot. Whereas if they would have pulled the trigger against Dominic tonight, they had a really good shot.
Yeah. It is interesting. I mean, yeah. So next time, you know, the four of them split the votes on Dominic and Seabass. You know, they vote out Dominic tonight. Then they split them votes on Wendell and Seabass.
Who does?
The four, the Kellen, Angela. This is my fan fiction four, right? The Laurel, Donathan, Kellen, and Angela, who, you know, probably don't like each other at all, right? Because they've voted against each other repeatedly. Mm-hmm. So, but in my mind, like, that would be the strategic move for all these guys. You know, vote out Dominic tonight, split the votes next week on Seabass and Wendell, vote out the remaining one, and then boom, you're in the four.
Does Sebastian getting the extra vote tonight, which I did like that they brought back a vote that Kellen misplayed earlier this season. I thought that was a nice touch when they said, oh, it's the secret vote against Michaela. Like, Michaela, what? yes. And then Kellen misplayed it also earlier this season. So
you like them bringing, I was so salty. Yeah.
Why? You want your vote?
Yes.
Maybe it comes back in the finale.
I wanted the curse reversed.
Maybe it'll come back in the finale. Who knows? Look, the curse is waiting for you to come back.
I know the curse is waiting, not the reversal.
Yeah. But so Sebastian having an extra vote here at the final six, does that create any possibility there for him? To me, I just feel like nothing matters because Dominic and Wendell still have their idols.
Yeah. I mean, that's the frustrating thing. Like, and another reason they should have made a move on Dominic and Wendell prior is just to A, blindside them before they were playing their idols, and B, you know, or just take multiple shots. But at this point, I mean, does Sebastian recognize the problem with Dominic and Wendell? You know, like that not being the remora.
Yeah, I don't know. I think he might feel like that. Hey, he's made enough, you know, relationships with people, and maybe he has relationships that he thinks that maybe other people don't have. Where he might feel like, hey, I've got Chris Noble, I've got Jenna, I've got maybe, you know, the Kellens and Angelas of the world. And he might look at it like, I'm friends with different people than those two guys are specifically. So he might feel like that he's got a different show, maybe Libby too. So he might just think that his social game is the best.
Yeah. Yeah, it's possible. I mean, and it could be one of those things. I remember, I mean, I always go back to this, but in, you know, Survivor South Pacific, everyone was like, yeah, Brandon Hance made it to the end, he would have swept the votes. And all the viewers were like, what are you talking about? It could be one of those things.
Did you agree with the decision to take out Kellen over Donathan for Dominic and Wendell tonight?
Yeah, definitely. That's a no brainer. I mean, Kellen has ties to both Angela and Seabass that Donathan doesn't really have. Kellen's proven to be better in challenges. Kellen's probably more strategic. You know, probably got a better shot at the jury. I think that's, yeah, for sure.
Yeah. You know, just to go back to something we touched on a little bit with, in terms of the Dominic putting the thing in Wendell's bag and Donathan called that out. The other thing about those, the other people, the other four that could have voted together tonight, I feel like that they didn't make enough of a big deal about that. I don't know why Kellen wasn't. Yeah. Yeah, what was that you put in his bag? What is this thing that you can't talk about? They never even gave like a good answer of like, oh no, that was a shell that I picked up on the beach. And, you know, Seabass got me talking about shells. And now I collect shells too. And I had this shell I wanted. Like, it was just like, whoa, it was a thing. Why do I have to show you everything? And that I just don't know why the other people did not arouse enough suspicion of, I have a secret and I want to tell Wendell. I don't have to tell you guys.
Well, but it seemed like their point was to arouse suspicion, right? They wanted it to seem like they were passing idols back and forth so that there was this, the fear of an idol. And honestly, like, that might have played a small role in why nobody voted for.
So you feel like they wanted to have that happen.
Yeah. I mean, the purpose of a fake idol, you know, you had that confessional from Wendell about, well, I've got this fake idol that I made. And the whole point of a fake idol is just to, you know, freak people out. So
is that too cute? Why not both wear their idols at tribal council at that point?
Yeah, I don't know. It's like, that's it. Like, they're like, I honestly, like, when I was playing with JT, like, I sort of, we felt at some point where it was like, we were just doing things to do them because, like, we felt like we were so completely in control of the game. And I kind of had the sense that that's what was happening with, like, here with Dominic and Wendell, where they're like, you know what would be fun? Let's do this, you know, because they're so running the show.
I just thought that Donathan was being pouty at Tribal Council and not really like, you want to come and drop truth bombs? Like, come, you're at Tribal Council. Now's the time. Let's get those truth bombs going. Get Kellen, get Seabass, get Angela on your side. Hey, these guys are going to play an idol. And You know, I just felt like that he was when Donathan or Dominic says to him, like, Donathan, can I talk to you? And he's like, no.
Yeah.
Like, okay. Well, what good does that do? No,
I agree. But at this point, I mean, I don't know. You're just losing your mind by this point. You know, I just to see all of the game. I'm sure he can see the game collapsing around him. And look, I think it's great that one of us is partisanly defending Donathan and the other is partisanly defending Laurel. And they're both wonderful people.
Look, for Donathan, though, that I feel like he was the only one out of that four that voted correctly, that he was the one person that put his vote in the right spot. Of that five.
It does seem like actually it is splitting hairs because like Wendell, obviously everyone's very aware of Wendell as being equally a part of this you know, incredible duo with Dominic. And I think that's a really smart read. That's a really great call.
And to also add to that, I want to go back to the very controversial moment between Wendell and Laurel at the immunity challenge where Wendell completes his puzzle and then walks away and is waiting for Jeff to say, Wendell, it's immunity.
Wow.
And then Laurel ends up slide puzzle. Boom. Jeff, I got it. And then and Wendell's like, hold on.
Was your call? You agree with the ruling, right? That he had to say Jeff.
Yeah, he should have to say Jeff.
He did like a flourish. You know, like I'm done flourish, but the flourish is not enough.
Yes, it was kind of like he did the thing like, do I have it?
I thought that was like boom, I nailed it, guys. Like
I think a boom is like a literal. You know, he didn't do that. He said he kind of just like. Backed away like he's also like double checking his work. I know his hands off the board, but the interesting thing though, Steven, if this was Big Brother, he would have had it. They would have gone back. A Big Brother would go back, check the tape. I think this came up in Celebrity Big Brother as well over the season. They'll go back and they'll do a photo finish. Interesting on Survivor, it's more like baseball and like balls and strikes where, you know, whatever the umpire says, there's no sort of, you know, manager challenge here that Jeff is the arbiter. They won't do a photo finish here.
But, you know, there are lawyers.
Jeff wants it.
Yeah, I'm surprised that, you know, do you think if Wendell had contested it, that Wendell might have won? I mean, it's
well, here's where I want to go with this, because I think that Wendell was very savvy to not contest it.
Oh, totally.
I think that speaks to the same sort of good cop, you know, attitude that he's fostering with the other people. And in the same way that they brought Laurel with them on the reward, I think bringing Laurel or gifting Laurel the immunity, and I don't want to say gift because she won it, but to not contest it and not create animosity with Laurel, where then she ends up saying, you know what, screw Wendell. He really was an a-hole during that whole thing. Even if it, you know, ends up going in his favor or whatever, he didn't create a rift. And we even saw her after the challenge say, how could I go after Wendell after I did that? Now, I saw you on Twitter and correctly say, look, this is Survivor. You can't be thinking along those lines of I can't go after a person because they, you know, it doesn't matter, you know, what they did to you. We've seen it, but, you know, it is the kind of thing where, you know, just like Dawn and Brenda, if Laurel took out Wendell on this vote after he gave her the immunity, then I think that it would be the kind of thing where, you know, he really might lay into her, you know, at the final three.
Make her take out her teeth.
Who knows?
Yeah.
Who knows? Wendell was, I think, very astutely had the great route. Now, if this was him and Kellen, would he have fought it? I believe he would have.
Maybe. I mean, I do really think, you know, I've criticized Laurel a lot for privileging friendship over strategy. I mean, that is one of the hardest parts of the game is, you know, divorcing strategy from these deep emotional connections you make. But you also really have to credit both Wendell and Dominic for so consciously, continuously reinforcing that friendship and that sense of loyalty with Laurel. I mean, Wendell has a confessional when they take Laurel on a reward where he basically explicitly says they're doing that. You know, they're like trying to build up her loyalty, trying to build up her friendship. So it's not like she's not making this move out of some, you know, irrational, you know, force. It's like this is an emotion that has built up over time and has been deliberately cultivated by these two extremely intelligent players. So you know, there's that. One thing I want to say, I tweeted this, but for all future Survivor players, you always call Jeff, not when you're done, but before you're done. Call Jeff just before
right. There's no time penalty if you ask yeah. Jeff to check your work and then you're
it
not
stops
right.
other people because like people will be like looking over, they'll be watching him.
And I never heard that before.
You can check your work while Jeff is coming over. And so as soon as he's gone, you're like, ah, here's what fixing it.
Right. That's interesting. I like that. Steven, I want to go visit something that Laurel said in the episode about how she said to the guys, look, my best chance is to go to the final three with both of you, hope you guys split the vote, and, you know, I end up coming up out on top. Do you feel like, is there any merit? And I know she said that she was just saying that because that's what the guys wanted to hear. But do you think, is there any wisdom in that? Is it better for Laurel to go to the end with both of those guys versus going to the end with one of them?
Yes. I was just thinking this last week. 100%. If Laurel has the opportunity to go with both of them, it's much, much better than just going with one of them.
Yeah. I mean, because if she does pick up the Malolo vote, hypothetically, what are there? Are there three Malolo on the jury in
Libby? Jenna, I guess Donathan, in this scenario, Michael, Donathan.
Four.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, you know, if she could get the four Malolo, and then, you know, if they somehow split the other Naviti, three and two, you know, that I guess there is that crack. I guess the reason why I'm not killing Laurel like you are is I just feel like if she makes the flip, you know, what, like, give me the next, you know, five moves that she makes great. After that.
Okay. So this episode, she makes the flip with Kellen and, Kellen and Angela and Donathan and herself. That's a 4-person majority in a 7-person tribe. Then that four goes to the final four. And she's in, she's got it, you know, like,
yeah, but you don't think that Kellen, you know, because she exposed herself to the risk that, you know, that Kellen and Angela flip back with Seabass and then take out her and Donathan and then go to the final three. So it's not like a slam dunk. If she did make the flip.
No. And we don't know her relationships with those. You know, we don't know her relationship with Kellen, et cetera. And, you know, Wendell and Dominic both have idols. I mean, the thing that I do, so like, you know, vote out one, you know, the other one has still got a good shot of making it. So maybe there's that danger in her head too. I mean, I don't think, I see this a lot where people say, well, she's a Malolo, so she's going to get all the Malolo votes.
No.
Actually, if anything, it's likely that the people who were on her tribe, who she betrayed and voted.